from the No Invite Podcast. No Invite Podcast.
Bang, 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 we're back. It's the motherfucking No Invite Podcast, and I'm Blaze.
And you got Steph.
And we are in the building, and it's basically like the year in review, right? I think this is going to be... this is going to be it. By the time y'all listen to this, it's going to be a brand new fucking year. You guys should be hopefully healthy and fucking, you know, made some kind of effort to not be some salty ass bastards. But, you know, I can't force my lifestyle choices on y'all. If y'all want to be a certain kind of way, then go on and be the saltiest pretzel motherfucker that you could be.
Well, 2019 was for all the salty motherfuckers, and 2020... hopefully, you know, you guys got watered down a little bit. Let's hope so. 2020 is going to be the year for everybody. I feel like 2020 is going to be a very positive year for everybody.
Well, it's, you know, 2020 is also like, you know, 2020 vision, you know. So hopefully you guys got a clear vision of who you want to be in life.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully that you guys are out there, you know, and you guys are taking care of business, mm-hmm. coming up with battle plans. I'm a firm believer that you don't have to wait till the new year to do it. But if
right.
you like milestones and that's what gets your motor running, then go on and do that shit. You know what I'm saying? Do it however you can. But make sure that you guys got a plan for your life, man. Plan a little bit, small term goals. I know it sounds corny or whatever, but it is what it is.
For sure. Yeah, I've definitely got to lay out a format for the year ahead, because who knows when it's going to come to an end.
Oh, we got a lot of interesting shit to talk about, and it actually kind of has to deal with that in a sense. So today's podcast is definitely going to be on some new shit, but we're going to go ahead and pay some bills real quick and shout out our sponsor, Saints Kicks. If anybody out there is into the whole hype beast, the Jordans, the whether you're like a sneaker aficionado or you're just like a novice beginner and you're into collecting shoes and sneakers and shit like that, make sure you holler at my people, Saints Kicks. You can find him on Instagram at Saints_Kicks, and he has all everything you need. Or you could go up to the shop, 650 Port Chicago Highway, you know, Bay Point, California, which we still call it the West Side. So I'm gonna say West Pittsburgh, though. We're gonna call it that because, you know, that's just how we rock. And they got everything you need. They ship worldwide. I'm talking about he knows his shit, so you never got to worry about buying no bootleg or no fake shit. I know for those people that like sneakers, you go online and it's like a 50-50 gamble that you might get some Gordons instead of some Jordans.
Some Gordons.
You might get some Schnadidas instead of some Adidas.
Uh-huh.
You might get some Geezies instead of some Yeezys. So if you want some official kicks, you want the real thing, not only that, but he has clothes, hoodies, all types of streetwear. Make sure you holler at him. Like I said, 650 Port Chicago Highway, West Pittsburgh, California, now known as Bay Point, California. And the number is 925-250-8413. There you go. Saints Kicks. That's our people. The No Invite fucking podcast fucks with them. I got my bread, 11s. If you ain't get yours, I don't know what to tell you. And that's what it is. We're going to go ahead and keep it moving. So, Steph.
What it do?
How was your weekend?
My weekend was...
Oh, week. Excuse me.
Well, my weekend, my week, the days are the days. And the last few of them have been pretty damn interesting. I quit one job. So, you know, I work multiple jobs.
Okay. What job? Because I know you're...
The one that I hyped up.
The one that you were over here
the one that I was... I'm not even going to say the name. So the one I hyped up, right?
I don't even get the name drop no more,
nah,
huh?
Fuck that. So look, I had...
Bougie sports bars.
They are. So I had to do what was best for me at that point because I already foresaw what was going to happen if I were to stay. And I literally quit 10 minutes before open and like wasn't even near.
So you're a real asshole when you quit.
Well, here's
like
the thing.
That shit.
Well, here's the thing.
I like that.
When somebody says they got it and you've never been in that position before and I'm trying to help you because I'm not going to have the motherfucker next to me.
I got it, Steph. I got it.
Oh, well, you got it? Well, then handle it. I quit.
Ooh.
Laughed at me, thought I was playing and I was out.
Mm.
And my boss comes out and I was like, sorry, I quit. Oh, didn't see that one coming. And I was like, sorry.
I guess James's beard wasn't man enough for you, huh?
No, it wasn't him.
Well, who
he's just a consultant.
No, I know that. I'm making these are jokes, Steph.
No, but look, though.
Thanks.
But here,
horrible
but here,
puns
but,
that
but
you're
here's,
destroying
but here's
right
thing.
Now.
I quit that job. I go to my other job to go get brunch and a drink. And then I'm talking to the regulars, tell him what happened. Then somebody else prominent comes in. Somebody else prominent comes in. Them two have a discussion. This motherfucker makes a quick phone call, comes back, and is like, oh, when you're done eating your food, go down here to my spot and just, you know, apply. I got hired. Like, I quit one job and I got hired, like, a couple hours later at another job. Like,
The other job probably didn't see your worth in this job, the new job.
I wouldn't say see my worth. They knew my worth. I was very critical to them. But they could have done a better job management.
Let me rephrase that. How about they didn't appreciate your work?
Yes.
Because when you have good employees, you got to treat them right. You can't give them everything, but you got to treat them good enough for them wanting to stay, you know?
Right, because I feel like at that time, I had already voiced what I had to say several times, and it wasn't acknowledged. So I felt at that point that was the loudest statement that I could make was to leave.
Yeah.
And you got to do what's best for you.
Yeah,
so,
you do. You can't be somewhere miserable, bro, because then that shit spills over into your fucking everyday life.
Right.
You know what I mean? You're not saying you got to be in love with your job, but you got to at least be somewhat interested. Yeah, you got to be somewhat interested in it.
And besides from that, living situation's been going up and down, but now I got it all squared off. Everything's going to be good, and the way things are rolling for me, everything is how it's supposed to be for the new year, so I'm really looking forward to it.
Change is coming, huh? It's changing.
A little unfamiliar, but I'm ready for it. I want it. I need it. I'm ready for it.
So look, I would tell you how my week went, but fuck what I'm going through.
Why?
Right now. Because it's very uninteresting. I just been working a lot. Ain't nothing new. Ain't nothing like.
That's how I was several weeks.
But see, you got more interesting shit going on in your life right now.
This week.
It may not be how you want it to be, but it is what it is. So instead of that, we're gonna introduce this new thing that I wanted to do, and it's what's it called? It's very interesting because of the current events and everything that's going on. Histrionic.
Sorry.
Yeah, where you're
histrionic.
It's actually a word. Trust me.
Oh, I believe
where,
you.
When somebody's just like that, when they're really interested in that kind of stuff. So, I want to do like on this day 10 years ago, on this day 20 years ago, on this day like a fun fact, right? Just so I could bless the people. And Patty actually didn't you came up with this idea, right? Or some shit like that. Well, it don't matter. We be high, so shit. Anybody could have came up with it. But either way, it's funny because of what we got going on right now. I wanted to read this off. So it says, on December 19th, 1998, which would probably be like, what, 20 years ago, 30 years ago? No, like 30 years ago. Almost. No, like 20-something. Hey, fuck it. Who knows? I'm Forrest Gump, so you know what I mean?
Oh, shit. You're never going to let go of that.
I'm never going to let go of that. Hey. But so look. So on December 19th, 1998, Bill Clinton was impeached by the Republican-controlled House for perjury and obstruction of justice. He was subsequently acquitted by the Senate. Damn. Right? Okay, so we could go a lot of places with that. But in case y'all been fucking living on the moon for the past fucking couple months, Trump was just impeached yesterday. And all them people on fucking everybody, that it's like when you get like one of those fake trends, or remember when Straight Outta Compton the movie came and everybody was like Straight Outta Concord or Straight Outta Pittsburgh and Straight Outta Frisco, like, you know what I mean? It's kind of like that. All I seen on yesterday was online was, yeah, he's impeached and this. And obviously people don't know that really don't mean shit yet.
Right.
You know I mean, that just means that they're allowed to attempt to give him a trial and get him out of here. You know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah, it means he still has, the whole case still has to go through the Senate.
He still has to, exactly. So it's hella funny though. It was hella funny. Everybody was just online, just doing way too much. I'm just like, whatever. But yeah, so it's funny. One day, 22 years to the day, well, not the day after, I guess.
Pretty much.
Say,
it's damn near the
same.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? That Clinton was impeached. They impeached Donald Trump. So that's kind of crazy right there. Just something for y'all to think about. You know what I mean? That's
weird,
right?
What about the other? Because he's the third. So it's Nixon. Was his date around the same time too?
You know what? I didn't really look into all that stuff.
Because if that is...
Our research department only goes so deep.
That's going to be weird if all three are around the same date.
Well, you believe in synchronicities.
That's what I was gonna say.
So if you believe in synchronicities, then you also believe that there's no coincidences. And people like to say, "Oh, it's a coincidence." It's not really a coincidence. Things happen for a reason. Things you see things. It ain't just because.
February
6th. Yeah. 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 It's only off by a couple months.
Right.
But yeah. So other than that, my week was regular. You know, just to keep my head down. Like I said, I'm just planning, plotting, trying to get all my moves in order, trying to get past these fucking holidays, make sure that I, you know, holidays are stressful. You know, it's so much emphasis is made on the whole act of giving and shit. But really, it's not. It's supposed to be about giving, but a lot of times it's about receiving. People are making it about receiving. It's like, what are you getting? Oh, I didn't get this, or I want this shit, knowing damn well that my fucking family can't afford it. And it's like, you know, I'm gonna make a big fuss out of it if I don't get it.
Well, because everybody, because of society, like, it's embedded in us, you know, around this time of year with the gifts and all that kind of stuff. And
I mean, that's cool. But I think also, but
we get that entitlement mentality.
Right.
You know?
Right. And I think, like I said, I think it's cool. I like the vibe of the year. I'm not really into, I don't subscribe to the whole reason why we do it.
Right.
Everybody's like, what's it called? He's the reason for the season. I'm like, no, he's not. No, he's not. Y'all should go read a book besides the Bible and y'all might know that. But you know what I'm saying?
Hello.
But like, you know what I mean? I just like, I like the whole idea of, like I said, the premise, and it's about giving. Like this year, me and my son are probably gonna go make food and go pass it out.
Mm.
I don't like to go do, first of all, I don't like to be like all on Instagram. We did that. I haven't showed it. And all the reason why I'm bringing it up now, it's not because I want to look fly or anything. It's because it's just to show people that you should do that type of stuff, and you don't need to fucking broadcast it on Instagram.
No, because what if that was you?
Yeah, I would. If I was all fucked up, the last thing I want is a camera in my face, bro. I really want that cheeseburger, but I want that camera.
Speaking of, really quick, tell me why. This is like on a total side note. Tell me why. This was like a few years ago. I walked out of the fast food joint in the morning. Homeless dude was like, oh, anything, please. I'm hungry. Here you go. I had two breakfast sandwiches. Oh, I don't like ham. Well, bitch, fuck you. Give it back.
That's like that movie.
He really did that.
That's like that movie. Scary movie. Where yeah, that's exactly in my mind. Exactly when you said it already, when you talked about a homeless dude in front of the store, I thought about that already. I was like, yo. In Scary Movie, when the bun, the lady walked by the bun, he's like, hey, miss, can you spare a dollar? And she goes, oh, here you go, kind sir, you hungry? Da-da-da. And she slid him a sandwich, and he looked at the sandwich and threw it at her. He said, bitch, I said a dollar.
I threw it at her head like lightweight softball pitch shit.
You know what I'm saying? Damn, that happened in real life, though.
Yeah, I'll never forget that.
You know what I told him? I'd have been like, let me see, and I would have smacked that sandwich out his fucking hand. Like, both. Now no one gets it. Give it to the devil, you scum.
Give it to the devil, you crazy as hell.
You scum. Now no one gets it.
Mm-hmm.
Nah, but see, I would be like, in my mind, see, in my mind, I do a lot of that shit because I can't actually just do it no more like I used to. So in my mind, it'd be like the fucking the Family Guy where they do a cutaway and it's actually happening what they're saying, but it's not really real. That's what I do in my mind. So if you see me staring at a person for a little extra long, it's because in my mind, I probably done slapped their ass already or something, or punched them in their face, and I'm cutting away to that. And that cutaway...
Is that why you're always quieter
at me? Nah, Patty. I'll just tell you your face if I wanted to punch it.
Imagining.
Nah, really, that's really what I do. I cut away so I could, like, you know. But yeah, what the fuck is that?
On this day?
Joey Six Clown came on, born in December.
The Q-tip, the clown.
Yeah, that's creepy, bro.
That's weird, right?
That's creepy. I don't even want to read that. Hey, clowns.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, with that being said, we're going to go ahead and take a little break. We'll be back in a minute. It's the No Invite Podcast on Blaze.
You got Steph?
And we out. Bang, bang, bang. All right, correcting your papers so nice and loudly.
Well, I did it right before she...
Yeah, no, you good. just giving you the heads up so later on. It's the No Invite Podcast. We always giving out podcasting tips to each other. I'm Blaze.
And you got Steph.
And we keeping it rolling. And since it's the end of the year, I wanted to do something that kind of commemorates not only the year, but really... It's the end of a decade. We're moving into a new decade. So all you motherfuckers that aren't aware of that, yes, for all you people that can't count, we got you. You know what I mean?
Some people don't know their time intervals.
It's okay.
Some people can't even tell time on an analog.
And that's my fucking fault for saying it. I don't understand how that works.
But anyways.
So? I can say what I want. They ain't got. I know, but it's my fault for saying that. Is what I'm saying. It's like, how is that my fault? If you can't count, how is it my fault if I say something about it?
When you say something, it's my fault when you say something.
Nah, I'm just saying. Well, exactly. So why are you saying? Oh, some people don't know their time intervals. It's like, so that's my fucking fault. Like why am I supposed to give a shit if they don't know something? That's what I'm saying.
Well, like I said, some people can't even tell time on a clock.
I'm not mad. I'm just making a point. Like, don't tell me how to feel. Don't tell me what to think.
Don't tell them how to feel.
I didn't tell them anything. I said if you don't.
Don't tell me what to do, Mom.
Hey, I said.
Exactly.
It's not my fault that you can't handle it. Put that way.
We're gonna be getting Patty and Mike very, very soon.
I'm saying shit. I don't see how you bringing that up got anything to do with what I'm saying, though. That's what I'm trying to say. And we got Goliath in the background. Yeah, let's try to make him be quiet by yelling at him. That fucking works. Let's yell at him so he could be quiet. I mean, yeah, that makes total sense, y'all. But now, look, on some real shit, we just fucking around. But since it's the end of a decade, the end of the year, I wanted to do our personal top 10 albums. And since it's personal and we don't fucking, you know, just whatever, however you feel, Steph, she wanted to do her top 10 songs. Yeah, I'm like, that's good.
Because I haven't listened to an album since middle school.
And you know what? That's just a fucking, that right there is just a testament to where we are and how music is being delivered, because now it's all singles. People drop more singles than they do albums.
Well, even if they do drop an album, like, I'll probably, if I don't like the first if I don't like the first 3 to 10 seconds, literally 3 to 10 seconds of even how it sounds, I will literally skip it. So I will only probably listen to if
they gotta catch you right away.
3 to 10 seconds for me. So I don't even really listen to albums, like, and even in saying that, that also goes to show the content of the music that's being put out. Because back in the day, I could listen, if the album had 15 songs on it, I'd probably listen to 12 or 13. Now it's like the complete opposite.
I was just gonna ask you that. It's crazy that you're saying that, because that's where I was gonna be my next question to you. So basically you're saying is you haven't heard in 10 year span, you haven't heard an album that you could say you liked most of it to where you could let it play all the way through?
Yeah. That's really sad.
I could dig it. You know what?
Except maybe yours.
Well, you know, I'm not, just so you guys know, she's not getting paid in any way, shape, or form.
Oh, absolutely not. But yours, I probably listen to.
She really,
like,
rock with your boy. You feel me? She really fuck with the music.
No, but you know what? I probably, if you had 10 on yours, I'd probably listen to like 6, 7.
You know what? To me, I consider that a successful album for any artist.
Yeah.
Because it's so hard to hit a home run where you could say you like that. Now, don't get me wrong, there's artists that have done it, like,
yeah.
So let's kick it off, yo, since we talking about it, because it's going to pertain to what I'm saying. So since we're talking about that, I want to say we'll start with my 10 albums, which I only got as far as to 7. So that says a lot also about how I feel about music that I like. You know what I'm saying? Because I listen to all kinds of shit. But for you to make it on this list, to me, 10 years, you got to really have impact in my life where you are a part of my life. Like, you know, there's certain songs or there's an album that you play like during a certain part of the year, like Christmas, maybe. What am I on right now? To be honest with you, I'm not on anything right now because I don't like anything that's good. So I'm just playing old shit. But like,
I was on an old school hype for a minute too.
Yeah. And it's not maybe even old school. Maybe it's just like,
well, just like throwbacks from beyond, from beyond 10 years.
Yeah. So look, my Nipsey Hussle, rest in peace, one of my favorite artists, been my favorite artist. I think I started listening to him around his Crenshaw album, which I'm pretty sure I'm super late to the party too, but you know, a lot of people, you know, they get their panties in a bunch, like, you new school Nipsey fans. I'm like, bro, let them leave him alone, bro. Like, let them appreciate a motherfucker.
Right.
Yeah, they didn't appreciate him while he was here, but maybe a lot of them didn't know. And the fact that everybody appreciates him now is what turned them on to him. So let them live one time. So Nipsey Hussle, one of my favorite artists. He came out with his last album called Victory Lap. And this is tough because I didn't want to be hella biased because I could have put like 3 of his albums on this list. So Victory Lap, the last one he did, that was one, honestly, that I could throw in and play the whole motherfucking all the way through.
That's, you know what, now that you say that, I could probably do that with Nipsey. He's probably one of the few, and you know what, that's probably why he wasn't as popular, because he actually had shit to say.
Yeah. I think he was, to be honest with you, you know how people say, oh, rising star, somebody that passes away or whatnot, like when somebody passes away. I really feel like not only was he had been a rising star,
oh,
but
yeah.
he was just about to break the stratosphere. You know what I mean? Like he was getting really famous. Like his album got nominated for a Grammy. He always had a high powered woman. You know, he'd been with Lauren for a long ass time.
Mm-hmm.
And he was just, you know, things were falling into place for him. Things were all aligning to him. I think that's why also it was so crazy when he passed away, because people were really like, fuck, like this guy was supposed to be the next guy.
And he already had a lot of major, major deals behind. He was more into investing.
Yes. So if we're talking about impact, not only just music and influence in music, he got his cultural impact.
Mm-hmm.
He was his music. He really talked about self-empowerment. You know, he really talked about, you know, getting, owning businesses, owning the property, owning the areas in which we grew up. But he actually did it. See, so
mm-hmm.
it's different. Like, motherfuckers rap about slapping people and punching them and shit. And you might see them do that in public. Motherfuckers kill a million motherfuckers in their songs. You ain't never gonna see that. You know, they're not gonna show you that. But when you could actually see somebody that actually raps and makes music and then talks about,
does it,
and you could see it in real life, he's making moves and he's this and that. And this was the coolest part about it, though, in a nutshell, for the impact part, is that he did it and not only just people that listen to his music noticed. You dig what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah, so, for sure.
So with that goes, that goes Nipsey Hussle as one. And these are no particular order. We're not going to name him in what's it called.
Oh, okay. In chronological order or whatever.
Yeah, it's not like, no, he's number one, number two, number three. It's not like I'm just naming them. And they could go anywhere because, like I said, they relate to it. They pertain to a certain place and time in my life. Kendrick Lamar, Good Kid, Mad City. When it came out, I was just paroled. It was literally on the radio. And then I listened to it and I was just like, damn, like another person that if people don't really listen to him, they should go back. This is an album that you should put on your playlist. Good Kid, Mad City. He also got Section 80, which is a fucking dope ass album too. And it was between both of them. So like I said, I don't want to do too much and keep having multiple people on there. So good ass album, cultural impact. He was everywhere. You know, he's doing everything. And he's another artist that came kind of from like the same generation, same cloth as Nipsey, you know what I'm saying? So I like music that has a message, like how you were saying. So to me, a lot of these albums are not really like the most popular of the pop fucking, even though this one is, and Victory Lap is now, but it's not like the most popular of the popular music that's out, you know? Good Kid, Mad City? No, I know that. I'm saying this was at the time, but I'm saying not all of them that I'm saying are going to be like that because, you know what I mean?
No, I don't.
No, I know.
I'm just kidding.
No, I don't know what I mean sometimes neither. But yeah, that's a dope album. That's another one on my list. I also put Fabulous, the Young OG Project. That was a good album. I like Fab. He got bars. That's what I look for when I listen to music. I like good production and good bars. And if you could actually throw some kind of concept, make it like a movie for me. If you really, really want me to listen to your album, make it an experience. That's all I can say, because from the intro, transitions, or even just the music and what you're doing in the music, like make it a movie, you know? If you could do that for me, then you'll get me every time. I'll sit there and listen to your shit. So then also got Drake, Thank Me Later. I was in prison when that came out. Patty, you got a pen? So I was in the pen when that came out. I had heard a song from him. I heard this mixtape. I was like, okay, he do got bars. So I checked it out and I was like, okay, different. Like I said, once again, it was an experience. It's like a movie, you know? You gotta think of it, when you're locked up, music is really your only real key to like the world out there besides TV, which you don't get all the time. And even TV is watered down. Music is more like an unfiltered, like direct form of what's going on in the world. So to me, when I listen to that album, I would remember where I was at and how much I would try to like visualize what the world was like. You know, this is what everybody out there is listening to, or this is what's on the radio out there. Or obviously, you know, this album is a hit, so a lot of people are feeling it, you know? So like, to me, it's all about the experience. I mean, make it like a movie for my ears, you know what I'm saying?
So definitely then, has to be relatable.
Yes. Yeah, so then after that, I'm gonna put myself on there. because I'm an egomaniac scumbag. And I want to make sure that I... I'm putting my first album on there, my first little EP, and that's Ninth. I had put a bunch of mixtapes out before that. When I was in prison, I was telling myself, like, yo, I'm going to fucking get out. I'm going to do this with this music shit. I'm going to start taking it seriously because I never did before. It was just a hobby, I would say, before, you know? I started doing it. It finally came down to that point. My folks and my producer, Alexander J, the one that mixed the whole album, he worked on a majority of the songs, a lot of those productions on there. He passed away, so rest in peace to him. It was just a moment. Like, I had built up that moment for a while. And like I said, it's an experience for me. And it was an experience not only musically I try to give people, but it was also experience for me making it and how it all came together.
Well, you know what? You're only one of two people that I personally know and or have seen, for that matter, who have actually done that. Like, actually get out and make all that they say happen.
Yeah, man. I got a couple friends like that, man, that I was down with, and they're all doing music now, and they're all out here. They're all basically, because people think, oh, you're in prison, you're talking negative, you're doing crazy shit. Nah, you be in there really thinking like, if you're smart, you're going to be like, I'm gonna come on, do the most. I'm going to do it like this, though. I'm going to do it the right way this time. I'm not going to get in no shit. You know what I mean? I'm not going to get in no bullshit. That's how you do it, because you want to survive. You're a survivalist, man. You want to survive. You want to make it out here. So you're going to do what needs to be done to ensure that, and while staying true to who you are. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? While keeping your integrity. So...
Well, and on top of that, it's also hard, like, for certain people when they get out with parole hindering you.
You know what's crazy? And I always found crazy. It's hard for people on the streets to do that. They've never been.
It is. You're right.
And it's hard. I think.
But I'm saying,
I think
as far as having the music as an avenue, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And making, doing right by it.
And also, like, and let me give some context to when I say that. Like, yeah, it's hard for people on the streets. To me, I feel like I did have an advantage coming out, and when it came to actually wanting to do these dreams, and it's only because I had so much time to think about it. I had so much motivation, because everywhere I had been, all the shit that I had been through, it's like I had a lot more. To me, everything's about motivation. When you're really into something, you'll do it. You'll be into it. You're like, and you'll get up and want to do it if you're into it. Just like how you were studying for that whole experience on learning how to make drinks. You really wanted it, so you were doing it, right?
I was.
And see, that's the thing. When you're on the streets, it's hard to find that motivation sometimes. Sometimes you get stagnant.
Mm-hmm.
So when I'm coming from the bottom and coming from everybody's in the lead and shit. So I had to make sure that, I came home and I put my foot on the gas, because I feel like I squandered it last time. I had money. I could have took my career. Who knows? And this is before, like, really the downloads and all that shit took off. So I could have been like... Really, if I'd have played my cards right, been cemented in this shit already.
Right.
But I didn't. And because I was fucking around thinking, trying to be super extra
fly. Been there too.
And like, time's the only currency you can't get back. I'm not currency, but that's the only thing you can never buy. You know what I'm saying? It is currency. You can never buy it, though. And you everybody gets the same amount. Everybody gets... Time is like the only level playing field. You know what I mean?
Oh.
Other than that, what you do with your time is up to you, you know? But you can get the same amount of hours, same amount of tickets, whatever. So go ahead, Steph, it's on you.
I thought you was finishing your list. I was going to say...
No, my list is done. I put me.
Oh, you did all you did all of them already?
I only did seven. Like I said, I only had seven albums that I could say, honestly, I listened to. I kind of said that at the top of the segment.
Oh, well, then my bad. You know my bad.
So
for my 10 songs, they're more current, if you will. One of them is Malibu Mitch. And the first, so she's out of the Bronx, so she's like the next up and coming, like, Cardi B type. And she's definitely got like her own sound, and she does like a lot of like remixes on like throwback joints. Like,
what's her name?
Malibu Mitch.
I gotta listen to it.
She's cool. Like, she...
I'll check people
one,
out.
One of the first songs I heard was she did a retake on Gotta Get You Home by Foxy Brown. She did, like, Who's That Girl by E. But, like, she did her own little thing on it. So I definitely fuck with her. She does her thing. Now, these are songs. But Cardi B, when she came out with Red Bars, because I felt like...
Red Bars?
Red Bar. You never heard that one? That was, like, when one of her first, like, songs that she... songs, music videos that she put out before she was like big, yeah. And she was all Everybody in the video is just...
See, you know what? That's how you know you're a real Cardi B. Like, you was really fucking with her before.
Oh, I was fucking with her, like, way... Like, before she even had 100,000 followers. And when I would be like, oh, look at her. She's funny. Like, share her videos. My homegirls and everybody... She's annoying. I don't want to hear women. Oh my God, Cardi B. It's like now you're just like, bitch, you wasn't fucking with her back then. Like,
and you know what?
Me.
Not to act like that, but that's, see, that's different, right? Like I don't like when people act like that and they just because they're overprotective of an artist, but it's different for you because you really, you could see that that's not what it was. It's not you were being overprotective. They just really genuinely didn't like it. And now you can see that they only like it because everybody else likes it.
Exactly.
And they're into it, like,
But yeah, I fuck with the red bars. It's like, I didn't do my thorough research, but I'm pretty sure she wrote the majority of that song. You could, when you listen to it, it sounds like she wrote it. But it was still hard. It was still hard.
It was more that uncut shit.
It sounds like her when she talks shit, but it was more authentic than most of her new shit.
And you know what? Nah, it's because you know what? They just
she's
gave
more
her some
commercial
love.
Now.
Yeah, they get she just tightened it up. You know, once you get.
But it was still like, you got to listen to the song.
Yeah.
And one, I do have a couple albums on here. So I got Tory Lanez, Chicks Tapes, 4 and 5. I like number 4 better though. I definitely fuck with Tory Lanez and those. I mean, if you've heard them.
Tory Lanez is dope.
Yeah, Tory Lanez go hard.
I fuck with Tory Lanez.
Meek Mill's Championships. Now I feel like with that song in particular, if you listen, well, the I like.
Which song?
Championships.
Oh, Championships?
You never heard it?
You know what? I ain't gonna lie, I snubbed Meek Mill, but I really was on that Meek Mill album, and I was on that Pusha T album, but go ahead.
But that song in particular, the lyrics really, really hit me. Like, it's very relatable, and he tells a story, like, the whole way through.
Yeah.
Which is, I
and
like
the way
those.
He spit it, like, super fast, like, he rapid fire that shit.
No, it was really good. Offset Jim. Add Me Up was like the first song that I heard of his, and ever since then, like, I've been fucking with him. Like, I fuck with him. Like, he's definitely my favorite artist out of Oakland right now.
Offset Jim.
Yeah.
Definitely gonna have to check that out.
Well, remember when I pulled up in that?
No, I know, and you'd be posting him too. Like, you'd be posting his music slapping like.
Oh, yeah, I do. Yeah, I know. I was gonna, I don't post him on my page, but I know what you're talking about on my stories.
Yeah, you know how on your stories you could put music. That's what I'm
saying. Yeah,
my
bad.
I seen him on that. Excuse the fuck out of me, Steph.
Excuse me. And then I got
Nip. We gotta edit that, Steph. Do we gotta cut that out?
No, we ain't editing shit out this motherfucker. Okay. So look, then I got Nipsey Hussle as well with that Grinding On My Life, and I actually got like a line. No, I got two lines from the song tattooed on me because at that time, it was one of those moments, in time
you
for
was,
me.
You was, that's how you was feeling.
And I got Hustler, M.O.B. You know, I be slapping that shit when I be driving like all the time. That shit go hard. I got You On There with the 5-Star Bars. That whole album and your new one as well. A lot of your songs like helped me through like I had my moment. You know, I hit you up and I was like,
yeah, you told
listening.
Me. Yeah. And you know, I appreciate that a lot because to be honest with you, when that's the highest form to me of recognition, it ain't it that you pay and all that other stuff or that you go to a show to me. That if you sit with my bars and you listen to them and you have a moment, like I said, what you're going, same thing with me with these albums that I'm saying, it's like, yo, it's a certain point in time, I was whatever. I may not have been going through some negative or it could have been, but it was there. It was present. You know, I was, that was my go-to shit. Like, I listen to it every day when I'm doing this, I'm doing that, or I'm to and from, you know?
Mm-hmm. So I got two more for you guys. I got Snow Allegra with Whoa. So when I found her, I was kind of surprised. I'm like, well, what is she? Where's she from? All this and that. So she's she's Iranian descent.
That's dope.
So her parents.
So her bars are explosive.
Well, she's a singer, but so look, her parents moved her to, I guess, Sweden. And so she's born and raised in Sweden from Iranian parents.
So she got the Swedish accent when she sings and all that? Or she just sounds like...
No, she sounds like she's just clear English. But her voice is beautiful. She's beautiful. And I liked a lot of... As far as like R&B goes and a singer goes, like I'm definitely fucking with her. Like, for sure, for sure. And then recently, I think it was yesterday, as a matter of fact, I found... that song called Racing to the Grave with Mozzie and Pac-Man, that shit slaps stupid hard. That's probably like going to be my shit for the most of the year.
That's how you closing the year out?
Yeah.
Say it. What's the name of the title again?
Racing to the Grave.
Okay, that's how Steph is going to end
in
her year.
In a black
that's her
Ford.
Hype.
in a black foreign. Look, I ain't got the foreign, but the motherfucker is a black. Is all black mobbed car, out. Though. Yeah. Yeah. Look, all my cars have been black. Murdered out.
That's right.
Murdered Steph, the fuck out.
Exactly. Steph B. Mobbin.
So look, anybody who knows me knows my cars.
She mobs solo from state to state.
Pretty much. I mean, if you know me. So, if you know me or watch me online, then you know. But yeah,
that's a good list, though. I fuck with that list. You know, some of them I don't know, but I know that I could.
You gotta check them out.
I gotta check them out. Like, to me, that's the hardest thing for me nowadays too. Is I need somebody to put me on music, bro. Like, send me link. Like, listen to this person, listen to that, because it's like, I'm like stuck in my ways when it comes to shit. So to, you know what I mean? I like the artists that I've been liking. And don't get me wrong, I get new artists that people turn me on to, and I add them to the repertoire too. You know that, but man, send me links, bro.
Oh,
send
I got
links.
You.
Y'all motherfuckers out there, send DM the No Invite Podcast. Send recommendations, yo. For real. You know what I mean?
But you know what, though? Is... Oh, my God. I just had a brain fart. I totally forgot what I was going to fucking say.
Oh, well, good, because that gives me a time. And if that shit's whack, bro, I'm going to block you, just so you know.
Oh, my God.
So don't send me no bullshit-ass music. Don't send me your mixtape and it sounds like ass, because I'll block your shit. I'm avoiding all negativity. That's part of my 2000. My resolution is I'm avoiding all negativity. So that means bullshit,
I'm
too.
I'm avoiding all red motherfucking flags, be it relationship, friendship, whatever the fuck shit.
What about your period? How are you going to avoid that?
Fuck that bitch, too.
Yeah, red flags.
No, that bitch is under... Nah. That bitch is regulated with... that bitch is already regulated.
Okay, that's too much information. This is
she's regulated.
It was meant to be a joke that we just, like, a small speed bump, you just doop and just keep riding. But anyways, look, Steph, so we're going to go keep it moving. You know, I don't like to get political, but I wanted to get your... because Patty over here, you know, once again, we're talking about bodily functions and it's making Patty uncomfortable. Your body does stuff, Patty. Everybody's body does stuff. But we'll talk about the impeachment.
Crickets.
Yeah. No, it's because she don't feel good today, so I'm not getting much of a reaction out of her. But I'm still going to say what I say regardless. I'm going to keep shooting, you know what I mean? Just because you miss don't mean that you stop. You know what I mean? One's going to hit her. I talked about red flags, and she, you know, that did it for Patty.
Isn't that what he said? I was trying to think of
I'm all bleh, bleh, bleh.
With the scary movie.
Anyway, scary movie. Hey,
that
shit.
What was that, Porky Pig?
Wow, that's hey. We're living out the movies now. So look, the impeachment though.
Oh Lord. You know what's so funny? I don't know if I mentioned this to you already. Oh no, you do, but not the second part. So a while ago, I had mentioned that part of my family and I no longer speak because of this whole Trump conversation that was had with myself and my family.
It was like a Trump Royal Rumble, huh?
You could say that.
Though more like they mopped you.
They didn't mop me.
They jumped you, though.
Well, yeah. They tried to double team me.
So you held
your own? But I held my own.
Okay.
Held my own.
Steph,
so
from the shoulders with Steph, that should be the fucking name of the segment.
Oh yeah,
from the shoulders with Steph.
Let's do it. That's it.
Go heads up.
Let's do it. Let's
hey,
do
it's
it.
Your segment. I'm just
got
free ideas.
You hit it. No, but so look. So now here's my point. Now after they did all that bullshit, all that nonsense with that topic of Trump. Now look at them. Now they look stupid as fuck because now the motherfucker got impeached, even though it's not like 100%.
Yeah.
But it's like now it's like all that was for nothing. You just cut ties with family over nonsense. Now he's out the office.
Well, my thing is like this. And it's like, man, I don't know why everybody's so happy. You know, you got people laughing and all. See, this is what you get. It's like ain't nothing happened to him yet.
But I mean, as far as for the sake of the argument.
Yeah.
There were family ties and bonds and relationships.
No. You're right. You're right on that part because obviously... he did something wrong, right? So they're it's just hypocrisy. You know what I'm saying? Like he does something wrong, but then other people do stuff wrong, and it's like whatever.
Right.
Like it's not a problem.
But obviously, he did something bad enough to get to this point.
Exactly, and they and all the people that are sticking up for him, they don't care. I mean, look, think about it like this. They might see your point now. Like people, if they have a brain and they're smart enough, they might see your point. Like, okay, I get what you're saying. They may still rock with them or whatever,
that's
them.
That's
no, I know,
fine.
I know that. But what I'm saying is like, but though, the ones that I don't worry about, but the ones that I don't like are the ones that they can't even see.
Right.
The real, it's in their face still, and they still refuse to admit that there's anything wrong.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I totally concur.
Because those are the dangerous ones. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You gotta, my thing is like, yo, like I said, I already come to grips with all that shit. You want to follow Trump, that's cool, whatever, man. But once you start with the racist shit and you think that's a blanket for you to hide under while you fucking think you could talk shit, it's not a bulletproof vest, okay?
Somebody's
going to beat your ass. Yeah. Or worse. And you see examples of it all the time. Now me, I just don't fuck with people like that. That's why, to me, be like that, I'm going to keep my distance from you, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah, because like I could, like if you supported Trump, fine, cool. But that doesn't make you an unlikable person unless you are like how you just said, if you fall along those other lines, because
the racist shit and the ignorant shit.
Mm-hmm. Because like we had discussed earlier, Trump actually, and Patty had opened my ears up to this, because we were talking about like, well, what has he done? What has he done? So I pointed out what Bill Clinton did. I pointed out what Bush did. I pointed out what Obama did. And I'm like, well, what has Trump done? Because I haven't seen or noticed anything. So the unemployment truly is at an all-time low. So people are employed. So he has done that. He has made improvements in certain aspects of communities. And but one thing he's also done is he's fucked up. He's trying to like use his power to his advantage, and he got caught and he got busted, and you know, he fucked up. He's just an idiot. He's an idiot.
He's definitely an idiot. It's crazy when you think that we have somebody like that driving the car.
But I didn't really think that he had actually accomplished anything. Like when it was Clinton, the economy was booming. When it was Bush, he fucked up and left a mess. I can't remember what
Obama's
any good
Obama's the
he
one
did.
That put the economy like how it is, though.
No, yeah, but I know, but that's what I'm saying. Like Clinton had it good. Bush fucked it up. And then Obama came to clean it up, and he put in the health care, and good and bad for some. And then Trump came along going a completely different direction, but although he did help with the cleanup and did help with jobs, he did.
Everybody, look, let's get it straight.
But he's still fucked up.
Let's get it straight. Your job as the president is to do certain things, to run the country, to oversee the country, to make sure that you do what's best for the country and represent the country, right? So what he did as far as presidential-wise and as far as what he does on the other side, they still very much affect each other. Because you're, like I said,
he's
you're
treating
supposed
it
to
like a business. It's not.
And that, look, whatever the case is, if he's doing his job, he's doing his job. But that's when he takes it, like you said, the extra shit where he was trying to have the shit with the Ukraine and all this other stuff that's going on, the racist shit and all the little crazy shit, the shenanigans he's been pulling, right? That right there, that's how he gets his fans. We already kind of agreed on that. But that right there is how he is what separates him from every other president. Yeah. This one's fucking it up because it's like,
he's different.
You're causing a lot of problems at what expense? You know what I mean? At the expense of
our tax dollars.
Well, I mean, a lot of these people, like I said, that follow him, not to keep going back into it, they follow him because he does something for them that they like. So what are you willing to give up in order to get what you want? And a lot of people are obviously, as long as it don't affect them, they're willing to give up a whole lot of that ain't just about them. You know what I'm saying?
Whatever happened to the wall?
It's getting built.
Is it?
They're building pieces
of it. But let's just say, with the next election coming up, right? Mm-hmm. Are they going to continue building if the next president says, no, we can... Like, the next president can discontinue it, correct? Otherwise, it's going to keep on going?
I think they could discontinue it. I'm not sure. I don't think it was, like,
law. Presidents have done that before. They have, like, if some... left a project that was ongoing, and then another president came in. I've seen some like shut down. We're all like,
yeah.
It's something, yeah. Because that's all of our tax dollars.
I don't know. I don't remember how the funding for that shit goes. But either way, it's stupid. I just seen a picture. No, I'm not talking about that. I've seen that. I'm talking about, I don't know what the details are as far as how the money and the funding for the
whole
thing.
Right.
But no, it's funny because I just seen it showed a reporter or a protester. They showed it. It was an article I seen on Instagram where he easily climbed over the wall that they built already. So it's like, what are you really building?
It reminds me of
fucking
Bart.
Money. Yeah. It's too big to be fucking like, to, Yeah, it's too big to be fucking trying to fucking monitor the whole stretch. It's like, dude, that's a lot of fucking shit. So, and it's stupid to begin with. You gotta do something different in order to stop immigration, because it's not gonna stop nothing. You're gonna keep getting it.
I think if they just implemented another way of entry for specific groups of people, like mother and children, and why they're coming, and you know, there should be like a different process when they come. Like, yeah, we'll take you in, but you gotta go through this intake process, and then determine from there. But this whole where it's like, oh, we gotta make it a mission to get over, otherwise we gotta deal with this and this and this. It's like, no, take them in, figure it out, whatever. Just come up with a plan.
You know what's funny though? But when they want to go,
what do you think of that?
Well, I think it's a lot of these people are refugees too. It ain't just
right.
People that are coming over here to steal jobs or whatever he was trying to say.
When they work the hardest.
A lot of people come in. They come over here for a better life. Period. They're running from the bullshit that's going on in their country.
It's the land of
opportunity. Yeah, and what's crazy to me is how we could go liberate other people and give them that and be like, here, this,
but
that,
you can't
and the other.
Come here.
But you can't come here.
That's so shit's we're gonna so go backwards.
That's what I'm saying. That's why it's bullshit. It's like you tell people that and you go fuck with their governments and knock their shit down and try to give them that, but then you won't help them out like that. It's like, it's crazy, bro.
Yeah, or you go over there, colonize it to a certain degree.
Yeah, because this ain't your fucking land to begin with. So
and give them only a limited taste of what it's like over here.
And like I said, and speaking of colonization, let's not forget how this whole country was even acquired, okay? So just so we know that, and we know you guys know where we stand on that type of shit. I don't want y'all to think that it's some bullshit. What was the last thing? Oh, so real quick, me and Patty were having a conversation the other day. Let me just go ahead and bring it up. How many minutes we got left, Patty? 4 minutes left. All right, we're going to try to make it quick. Me and Patty were talking about alternate dimensions, and I don't know if you understand the whole...
Mandela?
That's one of them. That's one little theory within that, but like the whole quantum mechanics or physics and how multiple universes...
I fuck with quantum physics.
Yeah, so you know how multiple universes and all that shit is, right? So we're saying like...
I clicked
Patty
the
was saying everything's so weird nowadays. She goes, I feel like we're in a different dimension, right? You're saying some shit like that?
It feels like for a moment it felt like
unreal.
I was watching the impeachment. Like I was in like some alternate dimension or reality. So I was like, this feels like a reality show, or like a movie.
Okay, so look.
Watching the impeachment,
on that note,
President Donald Trump. Weird.
And we got to talking about that. And what I didn't bring up in that conversation, that there's a theory out there going on right now that we're living in a simulation. Like, put it this way. Imagine in 1,000 years from now, let's say the Earth survives, we figure it all out and technology progresses. What's the next best video game or mode of entertainment, right? What if it was we create this virtual world and we could actually inject your consciousness into something, into that world, and... we could fucking, you could live out a whole life experience. You know what I mean? You could live a whole simulation of a real, another civilization. Maybe you could go back in time and live in that civilization.
I thought about that too.
If you could, so look, there's apparently there's a theory. I don't know how far it goes into it, because I read some of it, but I'm reading all of it. But they're saying that when they shot, when they try to scan or measure the farthest, I forgot. Well, the whole integrity of what the universe is made of, it came out to a code that was similar to binary code. So what they're saying is like the farther they go, they feel like this possibly we could be living in a simulation, and this could be like how you said, I'm watching me. That could have been your real you watching yourself.
I feel
during
like that
the simulation.
I've had those experiences. I have.
Well, you seen the movie The Matrix, right?
No.
You should watch it. I would recommend it. I know it's probably not up your lane. You think action
no,
and all
no,
that
no.
shit.
No, I just don't have time.
Because most girls don't like that type of movie.
No,
you know what
I
saying?
Like
not
it. I just don't
people.
Have the time for TV.
Well, when you have the time and you're like, let's put on a movie, I recommend you watch it, because it's basically the same thing. In the movie The Matrix, alien race came over, enslaved man. And what they did is they put him in a state of like a coma. And they created a world, a digital world called The Matrix, where that's where they lived. That's where their consciousness lived while they were really, their bodies were being harvested and they were in a coma. Because they said they couldn't survive the whole experience being in a coma their whole life. They would go into shock and die or whatever. So they had to create, the aliens had to create a virtual world, which is a simulation of real life for their consciousness to live
and
act out.
That's real already.
Huh?
That's already real.
How so?
Because, like, we all have a past life. Like, our bodies, our conscious is in our bodies. Right. So when our bodies have, when the batteries die,
consciousness leaves, correct?
Yeah, and we're okay, gonna we're gonna come back into another
but
body.
That's not the same fucking thing.
Oh, okay, go on. I'm sorry. I'm okay, go on.
The whole thing is like this. Say that aliens enslaved us. They turned us in cocoons, and they're harvesting our bodies, right?
Mm-hmm.
Being in that cocoon stasis, what they were saying is that they would die. Your consciousness, your body would eventually die because your consciousness that lives within your body couldn't handle being in that form for that long. So what they were saying is they plugged you into the matrix, like physically plugged your body, and they would transfer, not transfer your consciousness, but your consciousness would live inside the matrix where you could live a normal life and you would never know in reality you're a fucking egg somewhere in a sack of jelly getting the life sucked out of you.
Okay, yeah.
You get what I'm saying? That's why when you're like, that's real now, I'm like, no, it ain't. Don't say that.
Well, what if it is?
I mean, it could be though, but that's the whole point.
We're too smart for our own good.
Hey, that's the whole point. Like, we're talking about alternate realities and that's another thing.
You know, you guys know
Mandela effect too. Remember we were talking about that?
You know, we are the...
The Hadron Collider.
You know, we are the only species on this planet with an ego.
Are we?
Yeah. With an ego?
Who?
What other species?
Who says that we're even on this planet? What if this is not a planet at all?
The old lion.
I think we're the only prized species that you could actually measure and be able to tell if they have an ego or not. Because I know, like, with chimpanzees and monkeys and stuff like that, and gorillas, there's a hierarchy. And let's face it, the male dominance.
Is that just,
I mean, you could... For us, we would say it's survival mode, but how could you really ever measure whether or not it is unless you're a fucking monkey one day?
Can ego only exist if you're conscious of your...
Of your conscious of... Exactly. Or not even conscious of your existence, but maybe conscious of who you are. You know what I mean? A monkey don't know he a monkey, or a snake don't know he a snake. He just knows he's out there getting it. You know what I'm saying? Exactly. There you have it. We come full circle. But yeah, no, we're talking about all that stuff, alternate dimensions. I heard another theory that I read, just to wrap it up. I heard another theory where they said that in 2012, when the Mayan calendar was supposed to end, and they said that supposedly that...
No.
Well, you don't remember the 2012, like...
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Get the fuck out of your phone, bro.
I was looking up something.
Okay. Well, was it pertaining to this?
Yeah.
Okay, then I fuck with you then. They'll say, like, damn, bro, like, I'm like...
You know how many people... Like, did you hear about that? Did you hear about that dude who scammed all those people out of, like, their homes and their money and everything because the world was going to come to an end?
Nah,
in 2012, bro. you didn't hear about it? It was, like, all over the news.
Nah, that's crazy.
Oh, he scammed a lot of people.
I bet. He was like, fuck it, give up your world. Let me liberate you of your worldly possessions because you won't need
why
them.
Why would I give you my house, my money, if
because
we're gonna
you're
going to
die. Exactly.
But why give it to you?
Because you don't need it no more.
That's like some Charles Manson type
shit.
That's
some fucking Jim Jones shit, huh? But look, all right, so look, we're just going to leave it at that. I think we should have another discussion, and we should do a little research to talk more about these whole things because there's a lot of theories. I'm into that. That's one thing I am into. I'm into
You know what happens in 2020?
Weird shit, science and all that. What?
The age of Aquarius.
The age of Aquarius. What does that mean? Are you going to dance around and fucking act weird? And take acid and fucking, you know what I'm saying, hippie slap each other?
Why is it going to be hippie slap?
I don't know. It just sounded good.
No. No, no, no. Age of Aquarius is like the spiritual awakening.
All right. Well, let's get it, bro. I'm ready.
I mean, you know it goes in way more in depth, but yeah.
Shit. Or, okay, well, we might just have a new year when we come back. Might just have a little discussion about that. By the time y'all listen to this, it should be the new year. So happy fucking new year. Slap yourself. I also wanted to fucking end off on to make sure that I shout out my sponsors. We started at the top of this. We're going to finish at the end. Well, it's not the end. We still got Steph's little... was it from the shoulders
to
with
the
Steph?
Neck?
Ooh, to the neck with Steph.
Yeah.
To Steph's neck. I don't think.
No,
you wanna...
No. We ain't wording it like that.
So yeah, it's
we gonna have shoulders. Something real slick season two.
So check it out. We gonna pay some bills real quick. So I know that you guys don't know, but I know. And if you don't know, now you know. Bay Area Exotic. You guys like. You know, most people don't like sodas. Most people do. Most people don't like snacks. Most people do. For those people that like snacks, this one's for you. I'm getting real fucking corny right now. But nah, Bay Area Exotic, that's my folks. He got it all. He got all the snacks, sodas, different types of treats from other fucking countries. Stuff that's, it's not old. It's really like, it's good. It's like, you know, it's what they're drinking right now. Different flavors, peach Fantas, all kinds of crazy different snacks. All kinds of Dorito chips and different stuff. Like, you got to go to him. You got to go see him. Go on, if you got Instagram, go to Bay Area_Exotic. Check him out. He ships. He got his inventory right on there, so you could look whatever he posts. I'm pretty sure it's for sale. He also has a location, 650 Port Chicago Highway, in the what's it called? In the Short Acres Shopping Center. He got it. I tried the what's it called? I tried the Pepsi Blue. It was pretty good. I tried the Pepsi Blue.
I
want
to take some Cheetos.
Yeah, they do. Like, he really do. He got different cereals, too. It's not just, like, from other countries, too. He got, like, cereals that they don't, like, that they don't really make, like, limited run cereals that they don't. And then, you know, everything is, of course, it's edible. You can eat it. He's not selling shit that you can't eat. You know what I'm saying? So, it's all stuff that's in stock somewhere, but maybe it's hard to get or you don't find it. Like, they don't sell it in California. You know what I'm saying? Exotic cereals and snacks and all that shit. Make sure you holla at him, Bay Area_Exotic on Instagram. My peoples, he gets it. You should get with it, man. Like I said, if you into that, if that's your thing, because that is a thing and it's a big thing, believe that. Bay Area Exotic. All right, Patty, we're going to go scoot off. We'll come back in a minute and come from the shoulders with Steph. We're going to be at Steph's neck.
No, Lord, no, we ain't wording it like that.
All right, well, it's Blaze.
And you got Steph.
We'll be back. I'm fucking gonna tag Patty so hard in all these clips. Watch, if y'all would've see, this is where we fuck up at. I wish I had a remote so I could hit record, because we'll be so in the moment, all of us, like, we'll be in the moment talking some crazy shit between these takes that we won't get it. We got a lot of good outtakes, so believe me, we're gonna
have those remotes very soon. Anyways, we back at it like some crack addicts. This is No Invite Podcast, and we're gonna be, what was, oh shit, I like already done Fred.
From the shoulders.
We're going to roll into From the Shoulders with Steph into the advice segment. And if you were listening earlier, we was trying to throw out some names. We're going to keep it rolling with that. And we might tweak it a little bit later. But anyways, the discussion piece.
From the shoulders until
from the shoulders to the neck, whatever. It's the discussion topic today is going to be all about red flags.
Red flags.
Red flags. And I think it's a good key topic, as also it's conducive with going into the new year with the new plan format and everything. As your relationships with be it your significant other or just people in general.
Well, go on and kick it off, Steph, man. You know, kick that format, yo. You're doing real good. Steph grabbed the wheel. She's handling her business, y'all. Y'all better give it up for getting them comments and give Steph props.
Yeah, definitely, because if you've been listening from episode one to now, you can see.
You're a champ, first of all. You're a fucking G if you've been listening from episode one till now.
So, yeah, we're going to discuss these red flags. So, everybody knows you go through all these multiple different kinds of relationships and you get your heart broken and you cry and you don't give yourself time to heal and recognize A, B through Z, and you jump into another relationship and repeat it several times. Well, there comes a certain point.
It's pretty specific, but yeah, I could kind of say I know what you're talking about.
Well, just so they, whoever, you know, like for those who can't count, for those.
Those who can relate though, too.
Yeah,
the people
so
that do can relate.
I'm trying to just be as explanatory as possible for those who don't know any better. So, when you finally get to that point where you finally have like a breakthrough with your mental, and you start to realize, okay, well, I've been through this. Now I know what I want, what I don't want, and so on and so forth. You know, you'll start to recognize when you get into that new relationship that you're ready for, or even if you kind of jump the gun a little too fast, but you will start to see those red flags. And if you see them early on, then definitely act on them, I feel like. Because I know I'm going through that shit right now, personally.
Well, please elaborate.
Well, Just I've been through hella shit, and now I'm finally, you know, I feel like I'm a late bloomer, but I feel like I'm finally able to...
getting it together, like relationship-wise, or just overall, like how you think.
Mentally, spiritually, overall growth.
Having a breakthrough.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
That's what's up. No, I respect that. I think, you know, being late is better than never at all.
Yeah,
you know,
right? When also, like, your patience develops, too, I feel like, when you get to that point. And having patience in a relationship is, like, a major key factor. Because if you don't have any patience and you can't learn to respect people for who they are and how they think, how they convey things, how they give and receive love, because there's, you know, several different ways that people... you know, give and receive. Some people do it by with gifts. Some people do it by actions. Some people do it by words.
With their fist.
Oh, Jesus Christ. You would.
That does not... not me.
Say some shit like that.
I mean, I would probably say some shit like that because some people
Some people do.
Some people love with their fist. And I'm not saying that it's right. I'm just saying that's just what it is.
Them broads can handle it. More power to them.
Shit. Some of them broads be the ones dishing them ass whoopings out. What you mean?
Oh my fucking god.
Don't act like they ain't a bitch out there slapping their dude right now, telling him shut the fuck up.
He's just
taking it because he's a dude and he don't want to hit her, so he's just absorbing fucking
or
slaps
like that,
in the face.
Or like that one dude
that
who had the...
I don't agree with being women.
Or like that one, that Latin chick who had the gun pulled out on her man. Tell him you in a relationship. Like, I would not put up with no shit like that, bro.
That's crazy. That's a red flag then.
Oh, you think? That's beyond. Well, that's probably happened in that. That's probably happened to him before.
He probably... I'm gonna tell you like this. You stay with a bitch like that, come on, bro. Come on. Anybody,
that's
really
crazy.
Anybody, I get it. You love somebody, whatever. You know, it's hard for you to leave because I never understood why people stay in situations like that. It's like verbal abuse. Okay, you're not physically, but when you're physically getting beat up, like it's like they're physically harming you, bro. It's like, wow.
But sometimes with people who grew up in those environments, it's sad to say, but if that's all they know.
Yeah, then they think it's normal. Yeah.
Right. But then some people always lived like that, and then some people eventually come to a realization and they break from that, and then they eventually get into a healthy relationship, and then from there they always say, you know, the hardest relationship you're gonna have is the healthy one after the toxic one. And those are hard because I've been through that too, but those are the best ones because you learn more about not only about who you are, but what you want, what you don't want, and so on and so forth. But I definitely think patience and understanding and communication is like, you know, what you should, and feeling wanted are major things that you should have in your relationships.
I could dig it.
So tell your girl that she's pretty and she's cute.
Smack her booty.
Yeah, do that.
You know what I mean?
I get mad when my dude don't be doing that shit. I be getting mad. And then what's your problem?
Okay, so what are other red flags for you? You know what I'm saying?
For me, insecurity. So, like, if I'm telling you where I'm going and what I'm doing for the day, I'm going to be busy. I'm doing A, B, and C. I'm out. I'm letting you know where I'm going, what I'm doing. Don't hit me up with a fucking text like, are you acting funny? Woo-doo-woo-doo-woo. Like, no, motherfucker. I'm not. I'm out here handling business.
Well,
I'm
going to tell you like this.
But then you want to bounce out all fucking day and not tell me where the fuck you going?
Well, that's just, you know,
that's a red flag.
That's having a petty party. That's all that is.
I'm
going to do it too.
But I'm not going to stand for that. Back in the day, I might have.
Yeah, that's a red flag. Being petty is a red flag for me. And because I mean, small shit is small shit. But when it comes to stuff like that, it's like, don't tit for tat me, bro. Just because you know what I mean? Whatever, you know? That's not good. I think, like, another red flag is, another red flag to me is, like, someone has their phone on their hand all the fucking time, and then when you're not there, when you're not there, they can't answer their fucking phone.
Oh, I get what you're saying.
You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah, like I hate, like, that. You always got the phone in hand, but it's like when you call a motherfucker, I want to act like
I'm tell you like this. Like, for me, it's like, I don't give a fuck. You gonna be out gone to buy? Drop me a text here and there. Let me know you
That's
okay.
How I am.
Let me know you okay. You breathing, you're alive, nothing happened to you, and then shit, do what you gotta do. If we're gonna meet up at a certain time, or you told me you're gonna call me at a certain time, then hit me when it's that time.
Right.
You know what I mean?
I'm on the same hype because I'm going through some shit right now where it's like, motherfucker, all I need is a text or a call and handle your business. So if anything happens or goes down, I know what's up.
I'm the same way. Like, I need that because I need to move around. I need to be able to move around and not have to worry, not explain why I didn't answer a text back fast or where am I at?
Right, with
and who's
all that
with me, like,
right,
it's like, don't get me wrong, like, hey, you could be like, what you doing or where you at, but don't be like, where you at and da da da. Don't kick it off with who you with and where you at type shit. It's like, come on, man, that's red flag.
Yeah, that's just insecure. And if you didn't catch the memo about communicating, then I don't know what to tell you.
Jedi, I mean, yeah, I mean, that's, to me, that's a red flag.
Hey, do you think being able to spell or not spell is a red flag?
Can we define what a red flag is then? Because that right now just
it's like a weird question. Do you think competency and literacy?
Because it's like, what are you saying,
at
bro?
At a certain
like,
age,
you done mark like something? Half, like no, at no, least no, three quarters why? Of the male population off the earth
no,
right now with that
you know
one.
What?
Like,
no, because you know what I noticed.
Like I had girl. You know what I'm saying? He didn't use his apostrophe.
No.
He spelled this like that. But no, that's really a thing, though, the reason why I say that. Because people really like... But I think that's ridiculous, to be honest with you.
No, but think about it. If you can't spell a simple word like... I can't remember. It'll come back to me. When I tell you what the word was, you're going to be like, what the fuck? I feel like if you can't spell, then... I don't know. I can't really fuck with
somebody.
Bro,
what do you mean, bro? Some people don't know the difference between two and two. Like two, T-O, T-O-O, T-W-O.
I can't fuck with a dummy.
Nah, okay. Well, that's your personal preference. I mean, it's not saying that it's wrong. I'm just trying to figure out.
Well,
like,
because
to me,
asking.
I thought a red flag was something that could actually like be like negative towards you. Like it would
that
like
is.
Like be, so that's just a preference. It's not really negative towards
you.
Well,
that's
you.
Why
it's
I was
like,
asking. Do you think that is? That's why I asked.
Nah,
you
I don't think it's a red flag. I mean, it's not a deal breaker, but you know,
you
it would
depend
be.
On, you couldn't depend on that person to fill out paperwork for you if you couldn't.
Man, I don't depend on no one to put out paperwork.
What
that
if
means
you
she that means she
hands.
Needs to know my social security number, and
oh,
I just can't
no.
do it.
Oh, no, that ain't happening.
You know what I'm saying? Oh. Nah, I mean, you know what I mean? Nah, it's to me that's not a deal breaker. I would prefer somebody that I could at least have a intelligent conversation with. What I mean intelligence, I mean obviously by Forrest Gump standards. Because if you're below Forrest Gump, then I really can't fuck with you. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, I would just say like somebody like it's not a deal breaker though. Like if I met her and she was a beautiful soul, a nice personality, she was hot, but she was kind of dumber than a bag of rocks. I might be able to look past that. I mean, it's that's not all, you know.
I can't fuck with no fool.
But I no me neither though. Don't get me wrong. There's a difference between like being dumb and like being gullible. Cause you can be as smart as fuck and be gullible as fuck and just get manipulated. It's like, oh, I can't fuck with you neither. It's like because you could bend or you could be. You're just so gullible and dumb that you would allow something to happen to you and then just be like, oh, this is how I am. It's okay. Like, nah, it ain't
yeah,
okay.
See, I can't fuck with no dummy. Like, if you... Yeah. So, for me, personally, that would be a red flag for me. If you're not literate in a certain aspect, then, I mean... No, but I'm serious.
It's all love until Steph gets IQ
I mean,
test back
no,
and it's
no,
like...
I'm not saying,
she
like,
starts
you
acting different,
be,
you know what
I'm
saying?
I'm not saying you have to be, like, all the way
she starts leaving you on red
correct,
and...
But when it comes to simple things, like, come on now.
So you're telling me Radio don't got a shot?
Who?
Radio, the guy from the movie, you know, Radio.
I haven't seen that in so long,
oh my
I can't
God.
Remember.
So you're telling me that Forrest Gump, if he came with his best Mac and he can holla at Steph?
No.
Damn.
No, and I'm not being judgmental.
All that money, Tom Hanks, I'm saying
I'm
though.
I'm not
like,
being judgmental, that's just
Wilson,
me.
I mean.
But I think insecurities in the beginning of relationships are things that could be a red flag, but it depends on how you approach them
well,
and tackle them.
It's also what you tolerate, though. Remember we were talking about that, too. It's like, okay, what am I going to tolerate from this person? If you get with somebody, I think, you know, yeah, you should be looking for red flags from the gate. And then if you consciously choose to keep fucking with them, then you have to understand
right.
that they are who they are to a certain extent. And, you know, maybe they're trying to fix that. Maybe they're working on that. Maybe you could, you know what I mean? But if you got somebody that's set in their ways and you're thinking about getting in a relationship because you might be able to change them or whatever, then you're tripping.
Oh, yeah, you can't. Yeah, that's not
They got to be. Anybody got to be open to change. That's another red flag, too. It's like drinking. It's like drinking is a red flag if it's like how you act when you drink, and if it's a priority. If you, if it's always drama when you drink, if there's always an issue, if everything gets blown out of proportion and you start crying or whatever, you start violence and stuff like that, then that's a red flag.
Yeah.
And somebody could get their act together. Don't get me wrong. You could work through somebody with that, but you got, there is a breaking point. So for anybody that's probably going through that and you think that your chick or your dude's gonna just hang in there forever, I mean, you might wake up one day, you might wake up one day and just not find yourself by yourself. You know what I'm saying?
Or going through somebody's shit is a red flag.
Yeah, that's a red flag too.
Trying to like look over your shoulder in the phone. I mean, there's all kinds of things that we could list like for days, but the point I want to make is when you see those red flags and you're aware of what you want and what you don't want, if those red flags happen early on, like listen to them because decisions got to be made.
Well, you, I think they're only red flags when you're acknowledging the fact that you want something better for yourself.
Right. You're more self-aware.
Yeah, you're more self-aware because, to, you know, our red flags, somebody looking in the eyes, just whatever. That like you said, they're not used to no better. Mm-hmm. So they're like just whatever, and we all been to that point. We all have a standard for ourselves that we got somewhere along the life, and maybe it's a high, maybe it's a low, maybe it's, there's no standard, you know what I mean? But you know, you learn in life as you go along, you know, what's best for you if you're actually trying to better yourself.
Yeah, and I learned that I had to, you know, do what's best for me. I'd always put other people, you know, whoever I'm with, before myself, before my own needs, which that ain't happening nowadays. But we gonna get into more of that stuff into the next season.
Steph, you sound disgruntled.
A little bit, because now I'm thinking about some things that's gonna happen when I go home.
Hey man, don't bet. That's crazy. Well, just remember though, it's the new year, y'all. Y'all make sure that you guys do something with your fucking time if you ain't been already doing it.
Read a book.
Shit moving. Drink water, exercise,
mind your business.
Right, mind your fucking business. You know what I'm saying? Let me say that again. Mind your fucking business. You know what I mean? Stay out my garden.
And you know what? And if somebody, if you don't hear from somebody with the New Year's, like if you don't hear back from somebody in a while, don't think that they're just ignoring you. They might have cut your ass off, but give them space. They probably going through like a rebirth.
Don't be a stalker.
They're probably going through like a rebirth.
Get the signs. If somebody don't want to fuck with you, leave them alone.
Or they're probably just going through a rebirth stage. So yeah. let them sprout and shine.
Don't harass. Don't stalk. Don't be a creep. There's a lot of shit you shouldn't be in fucking the new year. So we just want to say thank you. Have a wonderful year. We're going to kick this shit off right. It's the No Invite Podcast.
And we outie.